Hello and welcome to today's technical update. My name's Craig Earlham, market analyst here at Alpari. Now I've been away for the last couple of weeks, so there's been no TA videos. So apologies for that. I am obviously back now, so let's have a look at what's been happening while I'm away and have a look at what we can expect now going forward. Now a few things have obviously changed here. Let's start with euro dollar, for example. The outlook for euro has changed slightly. Well, more of a time frame aspect, really. You can see that the euro continued to struggle again last week around that 140 level. 140 is a massive psychological level for this pair. We've seen it approach this level before, before pulling back. We've seen it approaching it again before coming back. And there's going to be a couple of reasons for this. One, as I say, 140 in itself is a key psychological level. Two, from a fundamental aspect, we've got the ECB, and people are constantly waiting for when the ECB are going to ease monetary policy. We know it's going to happen at some point. It's not a case of what if it's going to happen. It's always a case of when, and people keep assuming it's going to happen next month, next month, next month. And I think that's playing into people's mentality here. When you're approaching this 140 level, when you think that the central bank's going to ease, which is going to be negative or bearish for the currency, then it makes you more reluctant to buy at these really key levels. And I think this is a prime example of what we're seeing here. So we've seen it approach that 140 level here again, and then people have talked about the ECB easing in June, or more specifically Mario Draghi and Jens Weidmann from the Bundesbank have both spoken about the ECB easing, and then this has made people more bearish on the currency again. But from a technical standpoint, which is all we really care about as technical analysts, what this has left us with is a very bearish setup, or potentially very bearish setup. What we've got two things here really. Firstly, let's look at this. We've got this negative divergence. We've got higher highs being made on the price action, albeit only moderately higher highs, but much lower highs being made on the stochastic. You've got the stochastic and overbought territory here, and then much lower highs being made here, which means that we've hit these new highs essentially last week on much less momentum. Now this is perfect negative divergence here, which is bearish for the currency. But of course, negative divergence is a secondary indicator. Price action is a primary indicator. Let's look at a price action. We've got this nice double top forming, and we've got this essentially forming with a number of euro currency pairs, double tops, triple tops, head and shoulders. All of these are very bearish setups. But the great thing about these, for example, in this case, is it gives you an objective price target. So you've got this double top here with the neckline. I'd say around 137 with these double tops and things like that. I do like to use the closing price of the here for the neckline, and this one for me is around 137. So what I need to see now is a weekly close below 137 to confirm a break of that neckline. Now what I really like about this setup here is, based on the size of this formation, that gives us a target of 134. Now this is perfectly in line again with the 200 week simple moving average, and the fact that all of these coincide with each other really does fill me with more confidence, especially when it also coincides with these previous closing levels here as well. So this just fills me with more confidence. If we see a close below that neckline, then I'm going to be very bearish back towards this 134 level for now, and potentially it could go even further, especially if we do see some form of easing from the ECB. I also like the fact that we've got these two ascending trend lines. Now both of these are speculative trend lines, so they've only got two touches on each. We do need that third touch to confirm, and even if we don't get that, for me it's still a fairly good indicator in this case, because we've got all these other bearish signals. If we see these levels broken, even though they've only got two touches and they're only speculative, for me that'll still be very bearish signal, because the trend is still clear regardless of the fact that we've only got two touches. Let's look at the daily chart next, and it doesn't really tell us much. One thing it does give us is another level, this 136.73. Again, if 137 is broken on the weekly, then this is almost irrelevant. This is just a temporary support, but I would like to see this level broken, because the 61.8 fib level is key for me. It's one I always pay attention to, especially when it coincides with previous levels of support as well. So if we could see that broken, that would again fill me with more confidence. Same with the 200-day SMA. I think that's going to provide temporary support if we see it reach this level. The 76.4% retracement level, I'm not too concerned with at this stage. Doesn't really coincide with previous support or resistance. It is a round number, which means I'll probably be keeping an eye on it anyway for temporary support, maybe small correction. But the reason I'm keeping an eye on it here is because it coincides with this second ascending trend line. So when all these things pair together, it always does make for good potential support and resistance level. In this case, support, especially with it being on a round number. So maybe worth keeping an eye on that for potential support, potential correction back to maybe the 61.8 fib. But again, we'll have to see how this plays out. I am getting a little bit ahead of myself. I do think this is still bearish. We are seeing it gain momentum on the MACD. Yes, it's oversold on the stochastic, but we haven't seen any buy signals yet, so there's nothing really too much to pay attention to here. One thing that does concern me for the short term, which makes you think there could be some form of correction in the short term, is this on the 4-hour chart. Now we've got two potentially bullish signals here. Firstly, we've got bullish divergence. We've got higher lows being made on the stochastic and very clear lower lows being made on the price action. Also, we've got this potential ascending triangle. Now, this isn't perfect by any stretch of the imagination, and I fully acknowledge that, but we have this ascending trend line here. We have seen it broken, but no close below that yet, but we have got an ascending trend line, and then we've got this resistance here. And again, this isn't perfect. This first, for example, is not really a test of a resistance level. This is essentially part of a downtrend, and I've taken the upper wick, but because it coincided so perfectly with that next level of resistance, I've added this on more as a something to keep an eye on, some potential bullish signal. But again, I'm not necessarily expecting this to hold. This is more of a red flag for me as opposed to an actual bullish signal. But if we do see a close above that previous resistance and a close above that ascending triangle, then that for me would suggest that we're going to see potentially a move back to this 137.70 level, which was previous support and resistance. So maybe a red flag here, given the fact that it coincides with this bullish divergence as well. Cable next, and as you can see on the weekly chart here, this is still in a bullish trend. No real indication yet that we're going to see a reversal. So far we're seeing a correction, and this comes off the back of this very bearish candle here. This is a shooting star candle. Not perfect again, in the sense that the body's a little big for my liking, but at the same time it's still legitimate. That the upper wick is still 3 or 4 times the size of that of the body, so for me it's still legitimate, and it's got a red body as well, which for me gives me a little bit more assurance. We are seeing a red candle after it as well, but we are approaching now support. This is an ascending triangle. We've had 3 touches of this ascending trend line, so this is a confirmed trend line. So this is going to be a major level of support around 167. I'm still bullish on this pair, and I'm seeing no reason right now, especially looking at this weekly chart, to make me think otherwise. We did see that cross in overbought territory on the stochastic, but we're seeing that play out now. We're seeing it pull back. We're seeing that correction. Let's look on the daily chart, because I have added a couple of fibs. We have had it has been trading upwards. We have seen it trading higher and respecting the fib levels, which is something I always like to see. So you can see from these previous lows here, it traded up, hit that 50 fib level, the 61.8 fib, and then continued higher. Then we saw, once it broke the previous highs, we saw another correction, and we saw it pull back, hit the 61.8 fib, and continue higher. And one of the things I like about these trends is sometimes when you see something repeatedly hitting the same Fibonacci retracement level, it tends to continue. Not every single time. Sometimes it'll retrace further, sometimes a little less, but when it's hitting the same one repeatedly, it tends to be a good indication of to how far the pair is going to retrace. Now, so far we've seen it come back, and we're seeing it find support in the 61.8 fib. It has come a little further, but it's struggling to gain any downward momentum below this 61.8 fib. If we see it close on or above this 61.8 fib now today, that for me would be quite a bullish signal and suggest it's going to go higher. But what I really like about this, something I mentioned in the webinar yesterday and something I've mentioned on numerous occasions in the past, is the fact that we saw it respect these fib levels so perfectly on this move higher. This is when I like to add the Fibonacci expansion levels. We saw this Fibonacci expansion play out very nicely previously. Now we've got another Fibonacci expansion where it touched the 61.8 fib level before moving higher. So I added that on, and again, we've seen it respect these levels perfectly. We saw it respect the 61.8 fib level, the 100 finding resistance, supporting the 61.8, resistance on the 123.6, and then supporting the 61.8. Now I think for me this is probably pretty much played out. Now I'll leave it on for now just to see if it continues to respect on the way up, but because we've still got the 161.8, which tends to be fairly key in these Fibonacci expansion levels, as well as the 123.6, which is another reliable level. So I'll leave that on for now, but you can see that it's respected these levels all the way up, and if we can see a close above this 161.8, then I'm going to be very bullish, and I think we're going to see another move beyond that 123.6 towards 170. But again, 170 is going to be a very key level. It's a big psychological level. The difference between this and the euro is I think people in general in the market are much more bullish for sterling in the longer term than they are for euro dollar, so I do think that's going to be breached in the coming weeks, potentially maybe in the next couple of months. Your dollar yen next, and this is far less interesting than any of the other currency pairs. We're seeing this trading sideways. We've been seeing it this way for a number of months now, the yen benefiting from its safe haven status in these fairly volatile times in the financial markets. I'm not going to go into too much of that. We talk about it a lot in the webinars, about what's going on over in the Ukraine with Russia, with the West, and so on and so forth. It does make investors quite risk averse at times, and the yen is seen as more of a safe haven currency than the dollar. So that I think this is one of the reasons why we're seeing this. I think technically we are still set up for a bullish, for a move higher. Maybe it's just going to take something from the Bank of Yen to really spark that. We did have this ascending trend line on here. Let's go back to the weekly. We did have this ascending trend line on here. It was a legitimate trend line, touched 3 or 4 times. And now what I was hoping was we'd, if you look at the daily, for example, we'd seen it trading in this sideways trend. There's clear resistance being found around 102.70, clear support around 101.27. We've seen it breached on a couple of occasions, but that safe haven aspect of it dragged it back inside whenever we had further further escalation in eastern Ukraine. We sort of pulled back inside, but then we continued to see these two support and resistance levels act as key levels for the pair, and it continued to trade between them. Now what we saw was a trend line now breached them, and I was hoping that this trend line would act as support for the pair and effectively drive it higher. If we see it, a pair making higher lows and at the same time finding resistance around a key level, on this occasion being 102.70, then like with an ascending triangle, the same psychology applies. You'd expect to see that upper level breached. Unfortunately, the trend line has not really provided too much of a key support, so I'm going to remove this because clearly this is not carrying out in the same way. Trading range which is playing more of a key role, so this is the thing I'm going to be keeping an eye on now going forward. If we can see this 102.70 level breach, then I'll become much more bullish, and even more so if we see these two previous resistance levels, particularly 104.10 or 104.12. If we see that breach to going forward, then I'll become much more bullish up to these previous highs. But for now, we need to see 102.70 breach before I become more bullish, or potentially 101.27 breach to the downside before I become more bearish. And when I say breach, I mean closing. You've seen it breached on a number of occasions and it hasn't managed to close above. So a close above either of these levels or below for the support level will make me much more bullish or bearish. For now, there's not there's not much opportunity. It's clear there's always opportunity in the market, but if you're a trend follower, then this is a bit of a nightmare scenario if you're looking at a medium term trade. Of course, if you go down to the lower time frames, for example, then you start to see trends becoming more clear. So if you look down at the 30-minute chart, for example, you can see a very clear trade, plenty of opportunity there. For example, you can use a Bollinger Bands, as I've got on there, because in an uptrend it tends to remain above that middle Bollinger, and a break below would indicate that the trend is ending. You can see here that we had a break below, now we're continued in between the middle Bollinger Band and the lower Bollinger Band. So of course there is always trading opportunities, and you can find trends just by going down to lower time frames. But when looking at the 4-hour daily and weekly time frame, from a trend following perspective, this is a bit of a nightmare scenario right now, and therefore not the most interesting of charts. Euro dollar next. Euro's, like I say, it's still looking very weak against a number of currency pairs. Sterling is certainly one of them, being one of the stronger currency pairs at the moment, obviously now against one of the weakest, or expected weakest. We are seeing it hold up around that 61.8 fib level, around 81.60. We've got a potential hammer forming as well on the weekly chart, but of course there's still 2.5 more days to go, so there's only so much attention you can pay to that. If we can see a close below here though, that would suggest that we're going to see continued weakness here, and you can see that the overall trend here is fairly bearish ones, lower lows, lower highs being made here. And given the outlook for both of these currencies, I don't see that change, and I do see that 61.8 being broken, and I think it's only a matter of time, whether it be weeks or a couple of months, before we start to see it targeting these lows of 77.55. Of course, like I say, that's a bit of time ahead yet. I think we've got to see the support, and this 81.60 is a big support. You've seen it find support on here on 3 or 4 different weeks, so I think we need to see a close below here before we become more bearish. There's no reason why we won't see a bit of a correction first before we see that. But for me, longer term, looking at the longer term, it's only a matter of time before we start to see that head south. It did look like we were going to start to see maybe a bit of a push high once we saw that descending trend line broken. It never materialized. We've continued to see it grind lower and grind lower. Now that we've seen his previous lows taken out, then this is certainly still looking more bearish. One thing I would say is that I'm leaving this trend line on because you can see that it's continued to act as support for the pair along the way. So for me, this is still worth keeping on just to highlight key levels of support, or potential key levels of support, especially if it coincides with other levels of support along the way. But one thing I'll say with this euro dollar is the fact that it's moving down, it's moving lower in such a steady pace. These tend to be the scenarios where the fib levels tend to work quite well, and as you can see here, we've seen it push lower down to these lows and move higher. It's a finding resistance around that 38.2 fib level. Now that may be a bearish sign, may just be a temporary bearish sign, but I think these fib levels tend to work quite well in these scenarios. These tend, and especially if you're only seeing a 38.2% retracement, that's quite a shallow retracement. So that can be quite indicative of how strong the trend is. But you can see here it pulled back to the 50 fib level previously. And let's have a look. I've not checked this, but you can see here it pulled back, found resistance around that 38.2, failed to close above before continuing low. So these fib levels, and especially by looks things, 38.2 is pretty key on this right now, suggests that this downtrend is still fairly strong. Aussie dollar, things are looking much more bullish for this actually. We've broken above all the key fib levels along the way. For me, I'm only leaving this on now just to see what the reaction is at 95, because it's around number 76.4, not my favourite fib level. But I think the trend is clearly looking quite bullish here. If we can see that broken, then I think the next clear target there then has to be 97.56, or there or thereabouts, 97.50, 97.60, somewhere around there, these previous highs. Things are clearly looking more bullish here, but that 95 may prove to be a key resistance level, prompt maybe some form of correction, given that it's round number one of the key Fibonacci retracement levels, roughly in line with that previous level of resistance as well. But again, in this, as we've mentioned in the previous currency pairs, the fib levels are proving quite useful here. And what we saw here was we saw a correction. It came back, failed to close below the 38.2 fib level. Again, that's the fact that it's a shallow retracement suggests to me that the uptrend is still pretty strong. But it then bounced off the 50 fib level, which had previously, which you'd expect to have previously been support resistance. It's now acting as support on a couple of occasions. That suggests to me that things are looking fairly bullish. It also coincided with this ascending trend line as well. All in all, things are looking fairly bullish, and I do expect to see these previous resistance taken out, 95 then being the next target. But the fact that we had the 38.2, the 50 fib, now that 50 fib, sorry, is from the 23rd of October highs to the 24th of January lows, and this fib here, the purple one where we found the 38.2 fib act of support, is the 3rd of March lows to the 10th of April highs. The fact that these work together, almost all these coincided to provide strong support for the pair, gives me more confidence that this trend is still pushing higher. The 4-hour chart doesn't really tell us too much more. Maybe that it's running out of a little bit of steam, potentially, but to be honest, there's not really too much to read into that 4-hour chart. You can maybe add a couple of trend lines here, for example, just to keep an eye on this trend. But that there's nothing really too much to give away. I think the key here is on the daily chart here. I think this is shows a pretty strong uptrend at the moment. We have seen a cross in overbought territory on the stochastic, but we've potentially seen that play out now. We've seen a bit of an aggressive sell-off, so maybe worth just being a little bit cautious here. If you wanted to go down to the 1-hour chart, for example, and add another fib on here from these lows to highs, you can see that it's now finding support in that 50 fib level. So that maybe this correction, or maybe this brief correction, is already over. I mean, this is the 1-hour chart. It's now just turned the hour, so the pair failed to close below that 50 fib level. I think that could be fairly key. That could be a good signal that we're going to see another push higher. Let's see how that plays out. I think this could potentially be a fairly good signal here, but you never know. We could see a bigger correction, I guess. But this is looks to be a fairly good sign to me. Finally, dollar Swissy. This has been a bit of a odd one, I guess. This was a really favourable currency for me. This was one, the currency pair for me, this is one that was playing out really quite nicely. But it's kind of slow. We've kind of seen a lot of consolidation, clear support around that 100% Fibonacci expansion level, around 87.05, clear resistance then around the 50% retracement level. Let's move this onto the daily chart where it's a little bit clearer. So what we had here was, previously we had this this Fibonacci retracement back towards 76.4, or was it I think that's the 78.6 again, depending on which you use, 78.6, 76.4. If it pulls back towards that level, I like to just have a look at both and see which one effectively fits best, because people use both, and if it respects one very clearly, it was the 78.6 on this occasion, then you can't really ignore that. Now, the fact they've respected the 78.6 on that occasion is why I added the Fibonacci expansion level, and it's played out quite nicely. It came back down to this 100% Fibonacci expansion level before correcting. It came back and found support on that expansion level again, and now it's correcting. So, like I say, seeing a bit of consolidation here, potentially the formation of a double bottom, which we should keep an eye on with the neckline at that 50 Fib level as well. If we see a close above there, then that may suggest that we're going to see a fairly aggressive push higher, but like I say, for a while we need to see something, because for a while now this has been to an extent maybe a little bit uneventful. But if we did see a close above that 50 Fib level, given that double bottom which is formed there, then that could potentially prompt a move up towards 91.50, and as you know, that coincides there with that previous level of resistance. It ties in pretty well, also another level of resistance back here as well, so it ties in pretty well. So that's potentially something to watch out for here, but like I say, I think we need to see a breakout here. It's been too long that we've been seeing this pair trading sideways. On the 4-hour chart, again, it is looking fairly bullish. We are potentially seeing a flag formation here, which is a bullish continuation pattern as well. But again, these, as always, this is fairly open to interpretation, but for me that looks like a bit of a flag formation after an aggressive move higher, which is therefore a bullish continuation pattern. In this situation, the target level, based on that, you could either use the opening to the flag, which following the breakout, which would take you, say for example, if we saw a breakout now, that would take you up to 89.35, coinciding with that roughly that previous level of resistance. If you're feeling a little bit more aggressive, you could take the size of the flagpole and then project that higher. That's a very aggressive tactic, I guess, but then that would take you up to 91.08. So again, that would therefore complete the double bottom as well, which would therefore again give you an even more aggressive target over than that. Okay, pretty long video today, but there was a lot to catch up on. Join us again tomorrow. We'll take another look at the chart, see how things are progressing. And also, for those of you who haven't already signed, you can also sign up for our weekly webinars. That the next one is next Tuesday at 12:30 to 1:30. We take a much more in-depth look at the charts, look at a lot more currency pairs, indices, commodities, with myself, Josh, James and Phil. Okay, thank you very much for joining us. If you've got any comments, please comment below. And if not, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you.